This is the stunning view looking towards Coniston from Bramwood. We stayed at the eerie flat in Bramwood House, which overlooks the lake, and we explored the lake and its environs using the steam yacht gondola and the Coniston launch. Here comes the Coniston steam gondola, which we are taking to the Waterhead Hotel, where Donald Campbell used to stay with his entourage during his water speed record attempts. Here we are disembarking at the Waterhead jetty. Following our visit to the Waterhead Hotel and a walk around Tarn House, we boarded the gondola again for a cruise around the lake. The gondola is owned and run by the National Trust. It is a rebuilt replica of the original 1859 Victorian Lake steamer. The restoration and rebuilding was carried out by the apprentices at the Barrow & Furness shipyards and relaunched here in 1980. Gondola also gave Arthur Ransom the idea for Captain Flint's houseboat in his children's book Swallows and Amazons. We all know that the Cumbrian Lakes have a high average rainfall. However, when the sun shines, there are some dramatic effects, as seen by this rainbow touching the water. The interior of the luxurious first-class saloon is very striking, with red leather upholstered seating complemented by rich mahogany panelling. Pictures recording the restoration of the gondola and charts of Lake Coniston adorn the bulkheads. Large windows give unparalleled views of the lakeside, and in fine weather there is pleasant seating on the foredeck. The vessel is powered by a twin-cylinder 90-degree V steam engine with a slip eccentric reverse system and a double-acting slide valve arrangement seen here. The steam boiler is fired with blazer logs, these commercially produced logs being made from compressed sawdust. Having brought us safely back to the jetty at Bramwood, the gondola departs back to her Coniston boathouse, where she is berthed overnight. Today, we're travelling by the modern diesel-powered Coniston launch. The launch, with its hop-on, hop-off timetable, is a very convenient way of travelling round the lake. As you will hear later on, there is a freely provided commentary covering interesting historical facts about the area.
Brown trout, eel and the Arctic char. Fresh powder left over from the last ice age at over 80 to 100 points feet down in the coldest areas of the water.
Our first port of call is Coniston Pier and Village. At the pier head is the rather fine Bluebird Cafe. After touring the village and paying a visit to the excellent Ruskin Museum, we fortified ourselves with homemade food and ale at the Bluebird Cafe. After lunch, we embarked on the launch again to visit the area where Donald Campbell's ill-fated attempt at the water speed record in Bluebird K7 took place in January 1967.
The same way we're going now, we reached 297 miles an hour, and then coming back towards us on his second run, he started travelling at 328 miles an hour before he crashed. And if you look over to your left, you can see there's a break in the trees, a garden and a bungalow. Draw a line from there to the middle of the lake, that's where the crash took place. Where Bluebird and Campbell remain for 34 years, in 144 feet of water.
This is Sunnybank Jetty, where we disembarked for a pleasant stroll through the woods and lakeside back to Coniston Pier. From Coniston Pier, we caught the gondola back to Brantwood and thence home.